All right, I'm frustrated with building the astronomy tower. Let's take a look at the Goblet of Fire and Order of the Phoenix versions of Hogwarts. The Goblet of Fire version features some pretty cool changes. A lot of them center around the whole entrance hall, Great Hall area. Formerly, we had the Chamber of Reception out in front of the Great Hall. That is no more. That got replaced with this new courtyard based on the Clock Tower courtyard from Prisoner of Azkaban, because they used the exact same set for it, just redressed it a little bit. But all the details up here are different. It's got this cool new clock, all kinds of cool stuff. It's got big, big new entrance doors. I mean, does anyone ever really need entrance doors that are this tall? I guess Hogwarts does. But yeah, this is the new courtyard. I was able to copy and paste, well, a lot of this from the Clock Tower courtyard it's based on right over here. Just took out the fountain, took out the tree, redressed it a little bit, just like they did with the real set. Interestingly, though, that's not the only change over here. They also moved the Great Hall a little bit. Originally, it was higher up, closer to this marble staircase tower. And the link building that connects them was a little bit different. They made it a little bigger and more, I don't know, building-y for this version of the castle. They also made a change over here where they added this new archway that leads into the quad, which we'll get to in a minute. But this archway leads to a pathway along the terrain that I haven't made yet, which wraps its way around the Great Hall and all the way down to this landing area down by the boathouse, which, by the way, boathouse hasn't changed, but the stairs from the boathouse all the way up to the courtyard all had to change because this endpoint was different when they switched out the Chamber of Reception for this viaduct courtyard. So that's all changed. But as I said, this area changed over here. Originally, there was a big arch-shaped depression over here, and instead, now there's a much smaller actual arch that leads through into the new quad, which has the same basic footprint as in Prisoner of Azkaban, except it's got that archway, and the floor has been moved up and simplified. Pretty sure this is when the cloister disappeared, and we no longer had this way sunken down floor. Instead, it's at the same level as this front walkway here. And so this archway, which no longer has stairs over here, it just connects all the way through, goes all the way into the quad. Simpler, probably makes a lot more sense, even if it is perhaps a little bit more boring. So those are the changes over on this side. The other big change for the Goblet of Fire castle was the addition of the owlery over here, which just sits in an area that previously was just a big hillside, which I haven't built yet, but they added a new outcropping of pretty steep rocks and then stairs that I haven't built yet that go all the way up to the front door here, and then the owlery itself, which has all these interesting holes and ledges that were a bit of a challenge to bring to life, but in the end I was able to get them pretty accurate, I like to think. But this is where Harry runs into Cho, of course. And pretty nice view of the rest of the castle down here. But otherwise, castle really didn't change very much. There were some tiny things, like they decided that these two towers were going to be bell towers, and they added bells inside. I haven't added the bells because you're never going to be able to see it, except for right now. I'm really just focused on the exteriors. But in the movie, we do see an interior that totally doesn't fit into the exterior. And they changed the smaller slats, the louvers out here, into bigger ones, presumably so it would make more sense for the sound to be able to escape and then all of the birds to be able to flutter away in this cool shot that kind of pans over here and then goes past here and down there and swoops all the way up to Gryffindor Tower for one of the dream sequences. But yeah, Goblet of Fire Castle, pretty cool spot. There's a lot of views that we can take a look at that we never really get to see in the movies. No one video is going to be enough to show all of them, but I like this version of the castle. Not my favorite. Still got the Dark Tower here, still got the Defense Against the Dark Arts Tower, the Training Grounds Tower, at least the version that was redesigned from Chamber of Secrets. So yeah, not a bad version of the castle. But, of course, Hogwarts never rests on its laurels, neither does its designer, Stuart Craig. And so, for the next film, Order of the Phoenix, they decided to make some more changes. This is the Order of the Phoenix version of the castle. Changes here are smaller, but they are still important. For example, over here on this side, we've got a simplified bottom portion of this wall. I think it's because the quad got lowered so much, they figured it didn't make sense to have this all this deep dungeony sort of area when originally it was conceived of as being more at the level of the quad floor in there. So they made that tweak. They also went ahead and added some more spires over here. Originally, the clock tower courtyard, those corner turrets just had flat tops. But for this one, they decided they wanted to add some turrets or some spires. And those match stylistically with the redesigned spires over here. These two, they both got taller, steeper. And then these two over here got way taller, way steeper. And then this one and its buddy over here on this side, these both got added as well. Now, those ones I have mixed feelings about because, you know, this whole area is based off of the transepts at Durham Cathedral. And this mirrored sort of version of the structure over here, they did not add the spires to. So for me, if you're looking at it from inside the middle courtyard, the Transfiguration courtyard, you've got kind of a weird asymmetry there that I don't particularly like. But hey, you know, it's still not a bad version of the castle. The other change that they made was they added a window for Snape's office slash classroom, because in here is where Harry has his occlumency lesson, and the camera does this big pullback, and it comes right through the window, goes up into the sky, something like this, past those big spires, and that's actually the reason why they made the changes to the spires, because they wanted them to look more spiky and menacing for that that passage right there, for that shot right there. But yeah, that's the Order of the Phoenix Castle. Keep following and liking and commenting and spreading the word about this project. Make sure you visit the blog, hogwarts4d.home.blog, for all the latest updates. And hopefully soon I'll get the Astronomy Tower all finished up so we can start sharing some progress on that, because it's a pretty cool tower. Just got some frustrations with the blueprints. Anyway, see you soon.